What up, world? Back once again with another episode of Vantage Point. Check out the new logo behind me. Leave a message in the comments below and let me know what you think of the new logo. Make sure, as usual, that you guys are subscribed to the channel so we can keep growing the show. Artists. If you're Christian, send your videos. I don't care what genre. I don't care if it's rock, I don't care if it's gospel. This is not just a hip-hop show, so make sure you guys are sending those videos in, and see about getting you guys on the show. Enjoy the show. We got some amazing artists, some amazing videos, and we continue to grow. So once again, subscribe and enjoy the show. Peace.
Sunrise.
Perfection. I can do all things through Christ, who strengthens me. I'm safe for life. Who says that a Christian can't turn up? All the glory, all the praise to Jesus. I think I need a little calibration. $100 pockets and billionaire relation.
For this, When I wake up in the morning and I look up, I just thank you for another day. I know there's something so special and unique about me. Dreaming all night about my future life, it's hard to be still. When I feel excited about every dream I fulfill, and I live my life purposeful. If one door closed, you gotta know another's gonna open. Oh, I feel it so deep in me. The world, they are waiting on me to walk it out, live out loud. Nothing's gonna stop me, cause I be hard for me. I know where my help comes from, and I know that it got me. I gotta keep my eyes on the prize. Ain't nothing I can't achieve. Walking by faith every day, not moved by what I see.
I live my life purposeful. If one door closed, you gotta know another's gonna open.
I'm
Back once again with another episode of Vantage Point. I am your host, MC Sunrise Music, and my special guest today, Mr. Samuel Miracle Brown. How you doing today, sir?
Hey, I'm doing blessed and highly favored, man. What's going on? Great to be on Vantage Point. Nice meeting you, Sunrise. That's what's up.
That's what's up. So, off top, man, the first thing I noticed about you was your drip game is serious, man. Clothing and your videos, you be styling in
it. Yeah, man. God just told me that in order for people to really kind of respect you and to hear what you got to say, they need to see what God is doing in your life. So yeah. I make it a point to always stay sharp, especially when I'm ministering, go out there and, wear the suits, award shows, just dapper. So people will be like, okay. Okay, I see it,
Yes,
but I appreciate that.
Yeah, one of the videos that stood out to me was Boss.
Yeah.
What was the mindset behind that?
Oh, man, we were actually up there in Savannah, Georgia, shooting a friend of mine video, Ike Wilson, his love video. Mm-hmm. And I just started, in between the sets, I started playing Boss. And all the crowd was like, oh, man, they was getting it, And I was like, man, let's go ahead and shoot my video, too. So we started shooting my video in between his video.
Yeah, that's the best way to do it.
That was cool. So, yeah, multitasking.
Exactly. So you dropped like 8 albums in 16 months?
Man, God is working with me, man. He's just pouring. Hey, he pouring out things in me. And, today, like a while ago, people was like, why are you putting out so much music? But now people binge listen, just like they binge watch on Netflix. Binge listen. So if they like your style, then they go into the next song. They're going to investigate and see what else you got.
That's true.
So I just want to do what God want me to do. And when he give me the songs, I'm not going to sit on them. I'm just going to go ahead and release them. So the industry kind of gets mad at me about that, but I got to do what God said.
I was going to ask you if you felt like you were oversaturating a little bit.
Right. That's what the industry like. They're like, man, you got to stay with one single for like 2 years.
Yeah.
If that's the case, then you would never know about Boss. You would never know about God's Got It. You would never know about Somebody's Praying. You would never know about Calibration. You would never know about the new album, Horizon. Yeah. So you don't tell a comedian to tell the same jokes over and over. You look for new stuff from them. And, that's the same thing with movies. And so it's just the way God is, instilling in me.
That makes sense. So you actually landed a single on the Michael Jackson Redemption movie soundtrack. How'd that come
out? Yeah. Man, a guy named Troy Edwards, who was executive producer of the soundtrack, he heard Calibration and was loving it. God put on his heart to bless me with that, and I thank him for being obedient, because a lot of people hear what God says, but then they're not obedient. But he was obedient, did what God wanted him to do, and I praise God for it. And it's really an awesome awesome opportunity.
Yeah. That's amazing. So, I heard that you had an amazing testimony about that you shouldn't even be alive right now.
Oh, how many testimonies, man? I got so many. Most definitely. That's why they call me Miracle, because God did a miracle. Well, several miracles in my life, but that just shows how the enemy is trying to attack me, because he knows that my music, my ministry must go forth. And the unique thing about it is I'm able to reach not only the young kids, but also the seasoned saints, the traditional saints, the young hip hoppers. I just thank God for the ministry he's given. But to go back to your question, my first miracle was when the doctors told me that I had a rare fungus and it started eating through my sinus cavities and it had started pushing my eye out. And it was going inside the blood-brain barrier, going into my brain. Yeah. And they tried all the antibiotics they could.
I
lost you. He said, what have you done?
Hold on, I'm gonna start over.
Okay.
Hold on a sec. All right, so go ahead. I'll piece it in.
All right. And so when I was 12 years old, my mom told me, she said, what have you done? She had a bad dream about me. And I said, I hadn't did anything, Mom. What are you talking about? And she said, you've done something. You've done something. I've seen it. And I was like, what? So she made me fast for 3 days straight. Mm. A 12-year-old not eating anything for 3 days straight. I couldn't believe it. But I realized what it was for. It was for my miracle. Fast forward, it was for my miracle. And God appreciated that atonement that I did when I was 12. But anyway, so it was pushing my eye out, and that's the only reason why I noticed it. And they told me, are you in any pain? I said, no. They said, well, you'll probably die in your sleep. And I was like, man. You know, so I just went to God, and I told him, I said, whatever it is you need me to do, I'll do it. I dedicated my talents to him. I said, I won't do secular anymore. I just really just told him, you know, if he wanted to heal me, I knew that he had the power to heal me. But if he chose not to heal me, then I could still live with that. I said, I still know that you had the power to heal me. And God was moved by that statement because he began to heal me right away. I started throwing up and it was like the movies, man. It was like just, you know, snot coming down, throw up, tears coming down. I just knew God was cleansing me.
Wow.
And I went into surgery. They had to cut my forehead across here, and they pulled my face down, my flesh, and they drilled in my forehead. And they looked at the x-rays, and they looked at what was going on in my head. And they saw that it was a miracle because there was nothing like that. And the doctor really was impressed, and he really believed in God after that because he had wrote my death sentence.
Yeah.
And I thank God for that, man. And ever since then, I've been running for him and using my talents for him and staying busy, you know, just after one after another.
That's crazy because the miracle was on you, but he actually performed on the doctor as well. So it worked.
Right.
That's nice. Yeah, I like that. Right. All right. So we're going to get into a video real quick, and we'll be right back with my man, Samuel Miracle Brown.
Strong connection, kind of like reflection.
Like I'm looking at myself.
If I'm being honest, you make me lose direction.
I can't focus.
Such a strong connection, a one-time insurrection. For
Back once again with Vantage Point. I'm your host, MC, of course, at Sunrise Music, my man Samuel Miracle Brown. So you actually have a son in the industry. Did you have any words of wisdom for him, like as far as maneuvering the industry coming in?
Wow. You know, right now he's still trying to like find himself. you know, he's very talented as far as with the music. He can write, sing, you know, he has that appeal and everything. And he's just trying to make up his mind if he wants to do music. But my word of wisdom is, if he really want to do it, I got the connections for him. Hey. you know, he got the talent. I was blessed to have him on that song, God's Got It, because when he heard it, he was inspired. And I really didn't know he could rap at that time, but he was inspired. He said, hey, you won't. He said, let me hear that song. Let me get the instrumental. So then he just showed up at the studio with me and he just started rapping it. And I was like, oh, snap. so he didn't let me do it. What'd you say?
He did his thing on that. Ain't matter.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. He was snapping. And I was like, wow, man. And he has some powerful things that he's working on now. But he's a perfectionist. So he's like, I'm not ready to release it. I'm not ready to release it. And he listened to a lot of Kendrick Lamar and I think J. Cole. And they kind of inspired him the way he does his lyrics. But he's phenomenal.
Yeah, he's doing his thing, man. So whenever you drop a video, you know, tell him you got a spot on the show.
All right, I'll tell him. I will tell him.
So, I was going through your playlist. Who is Billionaire Minds?
That's actually in my record label. It's called Billionaire Minds Music. And we have a couple of artists that's on deck. You know, they just have to put forth the effort and we're going to, you know, match it. So just be on the lookout for Holy Ghost. Be on the lookout for Yahweh the Dope. Be on the lookout for LaDonna Taylor, Lonnie Crawford. Man, I'm sure I'm missing somebody, but you know, God is good.
So another thing.
Oh, yeah, Jay Caleb, my son.
Another thing I saw from you was you actually have a show on the Donna Walton Network called Bible Land.
Right.
Can I speak on that a little bit?
Oh, yeah, definitely. So like I was saying before, God gave us the talents to reach the youth. He gave us the talents to reach, you know, the teenagers, the hip-hoppers, the adults, seasoned saints, traditional saints. But this one particular is called Bible Land, and we use, like, puppets. They're real life-size. They're real cute. They look like little two-year-olds. Me and my wife do the voices. There are seven of them in all. And we do the voices and we just do things that will kind of nurture kids, like give them a role model, like put them in different situations and give them the answers to those situations. If they're being bullied, we have an answer for that. If they are scared to go to school because of school shootings, we have an answer for that. If they see their friends got on Jordans and they don't have on Jordans, we have an answer for that. So we're kind of like teaching them the word of God and also teaching them how to navigate through life. And it's very, very powerful. The show is about to get picked up by some major television stations. Nice. And we're just thanking God for it. Want to work on season two. Yeah. Right now we did season one. It's 12 episodes. So, you know, I'm just thanking God, man. Everything that we do is for the glory of God. And I have to give him praise. Everything. Even all the awards that God has given, these are all for God's glory. And it just lets us know that we're doing the right thing. And like a pat on the back, just keep on going. You know, when we get discouraged, the awards just say, hey, keep doing what you're doing. You know, somebody's recognizing you. So
yeah.
Bible Land is awesome.
Yeah, we definitely need more Christian content in this day and age.
Oh, yeah.
Especially for kids. So that's very good. So we're going to get into another video real quick and we'll be right back. My man, Sam America Brown.
Yeah. You sure about this? Let me look at you differently. Yeah. Taste buds going dry now.
Try now.
It's okay, I can cry now.
Cry now.
Hold up, got a child now. Throw it out, need to wind down. Please take it with a urge to. Pull it up, cause I thirst too. Made me feel like dirt too, cause I already don't deserve you. And what make it all worse too is the fact I ain't getting lit. Nah, I just kinda want a little sip. Like, drop, just a little drip. And I know it ain't considered sin. But the position that you want me in, what? Told me do not be consumed with it. I even struggle as I hold a pen, yeah, to let the people hear me speak of this. Why? Is it a thorn or a secret sin? I no longer wanna hold it in. Nah, help me get control of this. Hell, then my mind take me for a spin. Yeah, he don't want you and you can't repent. All I know is I'm so tired. I'm so tired of this. I'm so tired of this. I'm so tired of this, Lord. I'm so tired of this. I'm so tired of this. So tired, so tired. Liquor, lust, and lies. Way too many nights trying to live where I reside. So long, get lost. Cutting all my ties. Yeah. With liquor, lust, and lies. Oh, Lord. Plus, I don't need no Delilah. But I still got a problem. I ain't even tryna holler, but I need to shut my eyes up. Why see me dressing lesser, walking through the mall? I'm feeling all the pressure, even at the church. Got the tightest dresses. Who are we attracting? Who are we impressing? But focus. This is something that's inside of me. This is something that just gotta leave. Holy Spirit, you inspire me. I be good till I watch TV. Can't even go on my news feed. All I be seeing is shoes. I ain't asked to see this, no. Why do I want to see this, oh? Cause the flesh a mess, and it wants to mess. I want God the more, I want me the less. So what got to do, what he tell me next? And then after that. Yeah. That's if I want a better aftermath. Cause liquor, lust, and lies. Way too many nights, yeah. Lived where I reside. So long, get lost. I'm cutting all my ties with liquor, lust, and lies. Liquor, lust, and lies. Oh, I ain't sad, everything good. Yeah, I'm glad I did what I should. Always doing what I can, what I could. Yeah, right. Half truths, cut the combo short. Yeah. But the body language, let them know where you are. Not bragging, but sometimes it sucks to be smart. I'm thinking too much. I just wanted to stop. Cause liquor, no lust, no lies. I'm exhausted. Feel like I'm alive. Yeah, alive in a coffin. Reverse that. Feel like a dead man walking. I feel like that way too often. Ain't going viral is the new idol. Ride a wheel that was paid. Now I'ma go ahead, make a new title. Don't care about no title, cause all I ever really had in this life. Is my family and maybe a few Bibles. Yeah. Liquor, lust, and lies. Finally cut the ties. Take an exit out my life. Yeah. Why? Because I'm tired of all your lies. Time to kill my pride. Running for my prize. Yeah, hold on. So come out from where you hide. Liquor, lust, and lies. I curse you, don't you rise. Hold on. Yeah, hold on. It's reserved for God inside. My love, oh. My love. I just want you out my life. Liquor, lust, and lies. The lust of flesh and eyes.
All right.
Back again with Man Sammy America Brown. I'm your host, MC Sunrise Music. What would you say to people trying to get into like creating biblical content for kids?
Okay. Basically, you know, that you got to have the basis, which is the Word of God, but just break it down to them so that they can relate to it. You know, you have to speak in their language. So if they like to see images, then give them some images. If they learn by listening or if they learn by reading, you know, try to accommodate what they need based on your strengths. Mm-hmm. So that's what we do with Bible Land. We just kind of set it up to where they want to stay interested in it. You know, we act silly. Me and my wife both act real silly and kind of, you know, be on their level. So, you know, with kids, with adults, you might say, man, why is he acting so silly? But yeah. With kids, they enjoy that because they're kids. They have youth, you know.
You have to.
Yeah. Right.
So, again, something I do every show. I'm starting to do every show. What's one of the things that's on your bucket list?
We knocked off one of them this year. We went to Hawaii, me and my lovely wife, Karen. That was one thing. I think we want to go to Paris, maybe Australia, but that's so far away. Oh, my God. But it was long enough to Hawaii. But I think just to finish the work that God has given, God promised me that I'll be a household name. The ministry would be a household name. And I think the more that we do his will, the more that people will learn about Christ and realize that you can have fun in Christ and that it's not a burden to, you know, to serve God. A lot of people think it's a burden, like, oh, I got to be perfect. I got to do this. I got to do this right. Thus and thouest and all that. But you can be yourself. God has a sense of humor. He is, you know, he created us in his image. So believe it or not, whatever you think that you're doing and your cracks and your jokes, God has the same jokes, man. He is so funny, man. But I just want people to realize that he's here to, you know, he gave us dominion over the earth. But whenever we need his help, we just pray to him and he'll come down and intervene. So basically it's just, you know, by you embracing God and offering him to your life, like just inviting him into your life, then things will work out better. So that's what I really want to encourage people to just get a relationship with God, not just when you're in trouble, but even in good times. Good times are God, you know, laughter is God. When yeah. God said it's good. If a righteous man can sin seven times and God still consider him righteous, come on, man. Mm-hmm. Come on. You know, we think just because we make mistakes and even if we ask for forgiveness and we go back and do it again, like God's not going to, you know, forgive us. God is loving. His mission is to forgive us and to bring us back to him. Like, it's like a kid and a parent. If my child does something wrong, you know, I'm not going to stop loving him. I'm just going to, you know, scold him and say, hey, man, this is what you need to do. And that's that kind of love that God has for us. He knows that we're going to make mistakes. Yeah. And that's why he sent Jesus. So it's just such a remarkable thing, man. My mom told me, she said, you got all that word in you. You need to be a preacher. I said, what? So that might be on my bucket list.
So what's next for Samuel Miracle Brown, man?
Oh, I'm so excited, man. I got an adult contemporary album coming out. I'm writing it now. God is blessing me to write it. It's called Horizon. And it's going to be crossover, you know, so that everybody can enjoy it. Mm-hmm. And you know, all different races can enjoy it. I'm really excited about this album, man. It's like another level for me. I think when God gave me Calibration, I acknowledged him for raising me up in that song. And I'm like, wow, you're doing it again. So it's so important, man, to just listen to God, even with the music. I just can't sit down and write. I have to be inspired by God. And when I'm inspired by God, my hands are moving like this. I'm writing.
Yeah.
I don't have any control over it because my wife would tell you, I don't even know the words to my songs sometimes because I just wrote them and I go to the studio and record them. And, I have to go back and learn the words. So God is really with me. You know, it's not me. If I sit down and write a song, I can't write it, you know. But if God inspires me in the middle of a night and I get up at 3 o'clock or whatever, it's just awesome, man, the relationship that you can have with God.
Awesome. So as we do it at the end of every show, the floor is yours. If you got anything, any shout-outs you want to give, anything you want to say, floor is yours.
Most definitely, man. First of all, I want to appreciate you, man, Sirod's Music, for doing your thing, man. That is awesome. God bless you, increase your territory, you know, just for having the desire and the willingness to obey him, to interview, you know, independent artists on the rise. And I just thank God for you, man. Also, I want to just give people encouragement out there that may be going through things. God is always dealing with me. And the most recent thing he said was, when people tell you there's no way, and, you know, the CV on the police scanner might say, breaker, breaker, there's no way he made it. Or, you know, the ambulance doctor may tell you, hey, there's nothing we can do for you. And, you know, just like Mary told Jesus, if you would have been here, my brother would still be alive. Mm-hmm. And she was talking to the way, but she was talking about, there's no way, there's no way. And just like the ambulance people told me, there's no way you're going to make it. It's just like the CB people on a, you know, they told me there's no way you was going to make it. But God said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. So that means whenever they say no way, those are the facts at that moment. But the truth is the word of God. And the truth is what God says. And the truth always trumps facts. No matter what you see, even though those are the facts, God is saying, I'm the truth. So the truth trumps that. And that means that there was a way for me. There was a way for somebody out there right now that's in a difficult situation, financial. You know, it may be financial. It may be health. It may be you need a job. You know, God is saying, I'm the way. So lean on God. Quote him. Talk to him like you do a father and say, Lord, you said you're the way, the truth, and the light, and I'm depending on you right now. So those are my encouraging words. If you guys want to look me up, look up SamuelMiracleBrown.com. That's our website. If you want to go check out any of our catalog of music, the 9 albums, just go to any of the digital media circuits, iTunes, Spotify, Deezer, Tidal, all those places, and look up Samuel Brown Jr. And also you can look up Miracle. And it'll bring you right to it, man. I'm just so excited about what God is doing, and I appreciate this opportunity.
Of course, of course. Yeah, we're going to talk about that preacher thing, man. This has been another episode of Vantage Point. I am your host, MC Sunrise Music. My special guest, Samuel Miracle Brown. Peace.
All right, peace out.
Whatever I want, I got it, cause God's got it. Whatever you need, you can have it, cause God's got it. Don't let your heart be dismayed. Wipe your tears from your eyes, don't be afraid. Come on and trust Him. Believe him. There's power in the name of Jesus. Come on and call him. In spite of all, there's no greater name than Jesus. Whatever I want, I got it, cause God's got it. Whatever you need, you can have it, cause God's got it. Faith is the evidence of things not seen. If you know His name, stamp it on your green. I heard the measure of a man is shown through how many seeds he has sown in the name of the Holy Grail. Say you born again, so you can still be acting the same. Can't expect something to change if you never switch the game. Realize you're second in your lane, but the one who leads the grain is the Almighty. So gain your confidence and take a stand. It's time for you to stick to the plan. I know it's hard, but understand that you can't fathom how He sent His Son to die for all these sins. And that's how we begin on a narrow path leading to heaven. It's time that you start to believe, cause once you do, I know you'll see that even rain is meant for glee, because it's holy water sprinkling down to turn your mustard seed into the highest, strongest tree of life.
Lord, I know I need your might. Lord, I know this not my fight. Lord, don't trust in you tonight. I want me through to something bright.
I got my heart to see God with me.
Whatever I want,
I can have it. God's got it.
Don't let your heart be dismayed. Wipe your tears from your eyes, don't be afraid. Lord, you said in your word that you would pour me out a blessing. You would pour me out a blessing. Lord, you said in your word that you would pour me out a blessing. God's got whatever you need. You can have it, 'cause God's got it. Whatever I want, I got it, 'cause God's got it. Whatever you need, you can have it, 'cause God's got it. Whatever I want, I got it, 'cause God's got it. Whatever you need. You can have it, 'cause God's got it.